Hi, my name is Patrick. This specific video is regarding the IIT paper pattern and how to go about preparing for the IIT exam. So there are three sections mainly, apart from the GK which is there, so which is the verbal, the LRD, the quant and LRD. So we'll look at each of these areas and look at how to solve. Let's start with the verbal. So we're looking at 3 years paper pattern. So IIT 20, 21 and 22. If you look at the RCs are constant, 16 questions. The number of questions per passage may change. Here there are 5 questions and 3 questions per passage. Here there are 4 passages of 4 questions. And same way, 4 passages of 4 questions. That may change, but if RC number of questions 16 have remained constant in the last 3 years. In the 35 questions. Apart from that, the other questions are more based on grammar, vocabulary, etc. Fill in the blanks, etc. So same is the case in the remaining years. So you have something like crossword, you may have 1 questions. Something on parajumbles out here, 3 core questions, okay. Then meaning of a root word, which is also common as far as IFT is concerned. Look at that. Root words are normally there in Norman Lewis, Word Power Made Easy, right? And so on, and incorrect sentence correction. Same way, if you look at IFT 22, you have an antonym and synonym, 3 questions. Foreign words, I mean, how in the Indian context or whatever it is, English context is there. Root words again. Idioms. So look at these type of questions and try to figure it out. One of the common things that came in last year is the word usage in the sentence, 7 questions. You may want to see the type of question and practice accordingly. So one good way to practice maybe IIT is look at the last few years paper, see the type of question that came in, and then maybe prepare those type of questions. That could be a better way of doing it. So reading becomes a focus because there are 16 questions of reading. In the actual exam, maybe depending on the length of the passage, you may skip or do reading, but reading becomes an important part of the paper. Next is vocabulary. Right, so you can do GRE word list or Word Mar Made Easy or anything which is there. Then grammar, solve exercises. I mean, whenever you solve the different exercises, whatever mistakes that you come, do write in a book. And also do idioms or root words. Idioms useful for other exams as well, like that, etc. So it makes sense to go to the idioms, one some of the common idioms that could help. So this is some of the ways of preparing, you know, for verbal reading. Doing vocabulary, either Word Power Made Easy or word list, solve a lot of grammar exercises which are relevant to IFT, and going to idioms and root word. Coming to DILR, I mean, mix of logic and DI. So if you look at 12 questions logic, 18 questions DI, no big sets. There have been few 4 questions, 3 questions, 1 set, but no big sets. But DI, you have 4 sets of questions which is there, which good. Same way, if you look at IFT 21, 14 questions logic, 16 questions DI. Normally in DI, pure DI, you have 4 sets of 4 questions. Even in the previous year, if you look at it, you have 4 sets of 4 questions, and that Venn diagram is a separate question. Same in LR, this one, you have 4 sets of 4 questions. That's what DI is. But DI in IFT is tricky. It could be little, you know, too calculative and confusing. So in that case, it makes sense to be comfortable with logic. But yes, do both and go in that. Also, if your logic questions are more of 3 questions, 2 questions, 4 questions type of question, very few individual questions which are there, one question, but normally there are 2, 3, 4 type of questions. Puzzles, short puzzles with few questions in each series. So go to that, solve it. There was also sequential output tracing that came 2 years back. Okay, but yes, that's how it is. So go to the question, type of question that have come in IFT in the last 3 years, arrangement, scheduling, etc., tournament, and then practice those type of questions. That makes most sense in that case. But yes, do DILR as well. But DILR, learn to approximate. Tricks, techniques will help you to do it faster. Okay, so in logic, focus, maybe you can do cat puzzles. Not a tougher cat puzzle, the easy cat puzzles, like the tournament, etc. And maybe few individual questions can be comfortable, like coding, decoding, etc. As far as DI goes, focus on approximation. Trying to calculate completely becomes a little difficult. Do try to improve your calculations as well. Coming to quant, I mean, if you look at the major weightages for arithmetic, there's also geometry, quite a bit of weightage, but yes, arithmetic has a high weightage in the examination. Same out here, arithmetic and geometry have become the major weightage. And if you look at last year, so geometry is a good weightage in IFT, so please be comfortable with geometry. Next is arithmetic and modern max, which includes probability, PNC log, etc. Try to be comfortable with these type of questions. Algebra less, but we can't say. This year algebra was there in CAT, so it could be there in alpha. So be comfortable. But yeah, look at the type of questions again and try to prepare. It's more or less CAT type of questions. If you can be comfortable with CAT material, you can use the same thing for IFT. Right? So focus on arithmetic, modern math and geometry. This has been the main areas in the last few years. But yes, look at other ways of solving, like option, substitution, approximation. That should help you to be faster. So we do have courses for IFT. Also other workshops like SNAP, SAT, which you can refer to. If you're interested in interview VAT training, you can contact us. How to enroll? You can go to prep.patrickhunter.com or contact us at 9821314788 or support@coinacademy.com. All the best.